Welcome to another Pop Rock Short. Don't forget, if you like what you see, please hit the subscribe button below. All right, on to the show. 1972 has a lot to be remembered for. That was the year of the Watergate break-in. Women could still wear skirts in Kabul. And the Chevy Nova was the coolest car your grandparents could possibly own. 1972 was also a watershed year in power pop. Raspberry's Big Star and Todd Rundgren all released albums that captured the essence of the genre. That Beatlesque sound of pop with crunchy guitars, melodic hooks, and soaring harmonies. But another band got there first.
No matter what you are.
A full 2 years earlier, the band Badfinger released No Matter What off their 1970 album No Dice. Though the genre's name hadn't caught on yet, this song is widely considered to be the first power pop single. Badfinger was Pete Ham, Tom Evans, Joey Molland, and Mike Gibbins. The band originally called themselves the Ivies, and after years of playing and some shifts in personnel, they changed their name to the working title for With a Little Help from My Friends, and became the first non-Beatles signed to Apple Records. Badfinger got their break when Paul McCartney gave them a track he had written for the film The Magic Christian, starring Peter Sellers and Ringo Starr. These early songs sounded so close to the sound that everyone had come to love from the Beatles. Some even thought they were the Beatles, using pseudonyms to put out music that didn't get overwhelmed by the fuss of a Beatles release. I can give it. George Harrison started producing their next album, but during the sessions, the crisis in Bangladesh forced him away to plan what would become the Concert for Bangladesh. He chose Badfinger to be his backing band for the show. Todd Rundgren took over the reins, and the album Straight Up became their masterpiece. Including what I consider to be the most sublime power pop song ever recorded. Special love I have for you. Badfinger continued to record and tour, creating some great music along the way, but somehow barely making ends meet. The financial malfeasance of their manager, Stan Polley, led to hardship, despondence, and Pete's eventual suicide in 1975. Only you. The remaining members disbanded, occasionally joining other bands, though none made much impact. Evans and Molland reunited as part of another band that took the name Badfinger. They released two albums, and though each album had solid singles, neither did much to return Badfinger to their former glory. The sound they had pioneered just a few years earlier had now become infused with the energy of a post-punk world. Baby, hold on. Tom Evans took his own life in 1983. Yes, it shows. I think it's too easy to let their story be defined by the tragedy of their lives and what could have been. But for me, the story is about the gorgeous music they created when we had them. Both Ham and Evans said they did not consider the song Without You to have much potential at the time Badfinger recorded it, and the track was not even released as a single in Europe or North America. It's only fair that I should let you know. It has since been recorded by over 180 artists. Paul McCartney has called it the killer song of all time. Badfinger is a moment in time, yet somehow timeless. This is Bijan for Pop Rocks Radio. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.